I'm not sure exactly when this mic kicks in. I know I have an issue with it, so I'm gonna give it a few seconds. Hopefully it should be in there by now. This is Mr. Clement, your English teacher, and I'm here to talk about our first effort at writing our short story. So far, we've defined our plot sequences, we've created our action sequence outline. Now it's time to, and we've done our characters, our illustrations. We've done a lot of work. Now it's actually time to write the short story, which looks like this. Okay. So we have a solid understanding of our characters, setting, plot sequences, and we're ready to begin writing. What you will turn in? You will turn in a word processed, that means typed, draft of at least three plot sequences. If you need help with plot sequences, you can go to the Defining Plot Sequences assignment, which looks like this. That's this one here. Somewhere. There we go. Defining Plot Sequences. Your draft should be formatted with double-spaced lines, Times New Roman 12-point font, and contain the appropriate header information, i.e., name, date, course, or group number. You can set it up using the MLA style guide if you'd like. So I've clicked on that link and you can see it over here. This tells us all the basic information for how to do your basic MLA style formatting. You can also from here download either a 1997 2003 Microsoft Word version of a template or a Word 2007 version of the template. Once it's downloaded, you should be able to open it up in Microsoft Word and change the information in it so that you can make it your own. I just double-clicked on the header to get into the header information. I could change that to Smith if my last name's Smith. And your name is John Smith. Group 5, change the date. And I'm writing my short, what's the title of my short story? The Snake in the Garden. As you can see, the tabs, the indents, are all stuck in there already. This is 12-point font, and you have the lines already at two double spaced. So all you have to do is put in your own information at that point. That's an option for you. And you can get that at the top of every page of MrClements.com under MLA Style Guide, our basic formatting, and also from the post on which we were just looking, you have a link to it here. Your paper must adhere to the following grammar rules. Appropriate punctuation, this includes apostrophes for words that are contractions or possessive. Subject and verb agreement. That's when you have a plural subject, you need to have that plural verb if it's in the present tense. Same for singular. No sentence fragments. I don't want to see any sentence fragments. No run-on sentences. Two independent clauses, or an independent clause, and a subordinate clause, and then stop. Also, you cannot violate any of the grammar rules previously covered on our vocabulary tests. So if we've covered it in a vocabulary test, which you can find under vocabulary, there's all of our different vocabulary tests. If we've covered it, I'm going to grade for it at this point. So that's pretty much the end of it. You're going to bring in a word process type draft that needs to adhere to the MLA style guide or close to it. I won't mark off if it's not perfect. You can get the template right from here though. And it has to have these meet these grammar rules. And we're going to do at least three plot sequences. So plot sequences are what we did on, where is it? This guy here. This was our plot sequences. And that's when we looked at our action sequence outline and we defined where the scenes were, the plot sequences. So these are scenes. If I were going to do two scenes, I would write this scene and I would write this scene. So you're writing at least two scenes. And that is your homework. Where are we? There we go. That's your homework for this grammar challenge. Hope you have a wonderful weekend, and I look forward to reading your stories when you come back after the break. And that's That's it. Masalama.